Hi everyone, I'm John Meersma, and I'm a Cisco Collaborations Instructor at Sunset Learning. I want to welcome you to our series, Cisco Jabber, where we're going to show you the step-by-step process to configure the Cisco Jabber client. We're going to show you how to set up Unified Communication Manager, IAM and Presence, and then finally, we'll demonstrate how to get the Jabber client up and running. And our first demonstration is going to be to show you how to configure the CUCM server to integrate with IAM and Presence. Once we get these two servers configured and connected and able to communicate with one another, then we can bring in the Jabber client. But not yet. Our first step is going to be to get these two synced up. We're going to begin by logging into our Unified Communication Manager server, and we're using version 11.51 for this example. And the steps that we're going to show you are the same for all of the different versions. I mean, if you're using Unified Communication Manager version 10, 10.5, 12, you're going to go through these steps. So we've got 11.5, and let's get started. First thing that we need to do is go into System, Security, and we're going to go into SIP Trunk Security Profile. We're going to make a new SIP Trunk Security Profile, so we'll click Add New. We'll give it a name of IMP for IAM and Presence, and then we're going to drop down and check these four boxes. The Accept Presence Subscription. This is going to allow CUCM to accept Presence subscription requests that come in from the SIP trunk that we're going to apply the security profile to. We're also going to click Accept Out of Dialog Refer. This checkbox allows Unified Communication Manager to accept incoming non-invite out of dialog refer requests that can come in via the SIP trunk. These are different types of SIP messages that may arrive over the SIP trunk, and we're saying, hey, it's okay to accept those. We're going to accept unsolicited notification so that if we get a SIP message that's a non-invite, unsolicited, we didn't ask for it, we didn't subscribe to it, and we get a message from the SIP trunk, that's okay. The security profile is going to allow that. And then we're also going to click Accept Replaces Header. This allows Unified Communication Manager to accept new SIP dialogs that have replaced existing SIP dialogs. Once we've got these options selected, we'll go ahead and click Save. And then we're going to configure the new trunk and apply the security profile. To make the new trunk, we're going to go to Device, Trunk, Add New, and we're going to choose the trunk type as a SIP trunk. Click Next, and we're going to have to configure a few things here. We'll give it a name of IMP. We're going to select the default device pool. And remember, we're starting from scratch. We haven't configured anything on our clusters yet. We've activated the TFTP and the Cisco Call Manager service, but that's it. Our Unified Communication Manager cluster is bare. So all of this is going to be from the default or brand new configuration starting spot. Now that we've got this information added, we're going to drop down on our SIP trunk, and we need to add the IP address of our IAM and Presence server, and then we need to assign the new SIP security profile that we configured. To do that, we're going to go down under SIP information. We'll give the IP address of our Presence server, which is going to be 10.1.5.18, the IMP SIP trunk security profile. And then speaking of profiles, we also have to assign a SIP profile, but we're going to use the standard SIP profile. We can click Save, click OK. And then remember, when we save any changes on a SIP trunk, we have to reset it. If we don't reset it, it's very likely the SIP trunk is not going to work. And so we're going to click Reset and then Close. Now we need to go into our service parameters and associate this SIP trunk with the IAM and Presence Publish SIP trunk parameter. So we're going to go to System, drop down to Service Parameters, and our 10.1.5.15 server is selected. For the service, we're going to choose Cisco Call Manager. Now from here, we can search for the parameter, or we can use the Control F feature. And then under Find, we can type IAM and there it is, the IAM and Presence Publish Trunk. And we're going to choose the IMP, which is the SIP trunk that we just created. Click Save. We've created our SIP trunk, we've created our SIP profile, and we've configured Unified Communication Manager to publish that trunk when trying to communicate with the IAM and Presence server.